You guys are really rolling right now. You feel like each game, it just kind of takes on life its own. You guys get more comfortable.
Yeah, of course. You know, today was a back-to-back, so definitely was a bit more difficult in terms of fatigue. But the most important thing is we found a way to get it done.
The early games, back-to-back, is that kind of feather in the cap? Is it kind of like a
definitely was a first. You know, two games early back-to-back definitely was the first in my career. But we got off tomorrow. We got a half a day off now, so it's great.
Domas, you're the first Kings big man to have a triple-double since, I think, DeMarcus in 2017. Just speak to that and just – I mean, I feel like you've gotten so close games, but to finally get it, what does it mean?
Nothing. You know, the most important thing is, you know, getting a win. You know, it's part of the game. You know, my job is to get my teammates open, get them good shots, you know, and I try to do that every night.
You've hovered around it so many times, and here you are getting it this week. What was did you know you were so close to it?
No, not really till the end of the game when it was already settled down and fans were chanting like the beam, you know.
what was that like? I know they started, I think they were like gaining it earlier. Yeah. I mean, I know the pace was giving it around like maybe the 4 minute mark, but today was like 2:30.
Yeah, today was, I think we were up only by 8 when I was on the free throw line. You know, I was shooting the free throw and they started singing already. I'm like, okay, this is a bit early, but sure. You know, everyone's having fun. You know, we got the win, so that's the most important part.
I know you've been asked about, but what do you think just the beam means to the city just in overall?
A lot, you know. It means a lot, you know. We're trying to change this franchise around, and having everybody involved and feel part of it just makes it so much more fun. You know, everyone feels like they're contributing.
When you have you came out to this game, and I think your shot attempts were really kind of low early on. Was that kind of by design? Things, what was kind of?
No, you know, they were doing a good job of rotating early. You know, every time I had a chance to get shots where I usually get shots, you know, DeMar DeRozan and Zach LaVine was, you know, helping off other players. You know, and that just allowed me to find other guys. You know, sometimes it's going to be me, sometimes it's going to be someone else. You know, it's a team sport, and that's just how it goes.
You're over 20 games now into the season. You feel like you have enough of a sample size to kind of expect night to night what you guys should be capable of?
Well, yeah, of course, you know, but, you know, I've been in the NBA for a long time now, and everything can change. You know, there's teams that start bad and then suddenly finish on top, you know, vice versa, you know, so we just can't let down. Got to keep working, you know, and stay humble.
What has Malik Monk meant to this team? I know he's kind of energizing, running off the bench, and he's had, I think, 5 or 6 games of 20-plus points. What do you think he's meant to
him? Oh, he's amazing, you know, especially off the court. You know, he's a great locker room guy, very professional, always joking around, you know, but he's locked in, you know, and then on the court he shows it, you know. Me, personally, he's a pick-and-roll guy who likes to pass, so, you know, I love playing with him. You know, the more we can develop that chemistry, will be better for the team.